حالا بیا اینجا. حالا اینو بزن صورته. اینو بزن صورته. تو جو بزن بزن. بزن صورته. بزن صورته. بودو آفری.
دیگه اینو که من با نیازم با مسئولین این کارو بکنم، یعنی باید اون قسمت از شهر قرنطینه شه، چون واقعا یکی از بدترین جایی که احتمال شیوع هست.
خرج زن اون دوتا بچه‌مو بدم برم مرغ بخرم ندارم، پنیر بخرم ندارم، برنج بخرم ندارم، برو خدا به مردم بری. به اینه که موتور کار
میکنم داریم همین کارو میکنیم.
خدا وکیل ندارم من، خدا وکیل خودم ندارم. به عرض تعباد اینو داری خوشحالم کنم.
به خدا ما هم داریم میدیم.
حالت بد میشه بری ببین. این الان برو تو خونه، نمیتونه یاروشون اقتصادش هم مشکل داره.
Iran was one of the first countries outside of China to experience a major outbreak of COVID-19 and is now among the hardest hit nations in the Middle East. When the virus first reached Iran, the deputy health minister appeared on TV, downplaying its seriousness, while the cameras caught him coughing and mopping his brow. The next day, he was self-quarantined. Misinformation hindered Iran's response from the start. Only after the peak had passed did Parliament publish a report admitting that the death toll was nearly twice as high as originally reported. Dr. Talat Mukhtari Azad was the first scientist to identify the virus in Iran. While Iranians and outside observers say the government tried to cover the outbreak in its earliest stages, Dr. Azad disagrees.
طبیعیه که موارد میتونه خیلی بیشتر از اون چی که اعلام میشه باشه. اون اپیدمیولوژیست ها بعدها یه آمار کلی در خواهند آورد. نه تنها در ایران، در تمام دنیا اینجوره.
She says COVID-19 may have arrived weeks before it was confirmed, but peak flu season made it hard to identify.
اولین مورد که در ایران تشخیص داده شد 30 بهمن بوده. هیچ به این شکل نبوده که میدونستیم نگفتیم اون روز گفتیم. اون روز تایید شد، شناسایی شد.
While labs like Dr. Azad's have accepted testing kits from the World Health Organization, Iran's supreme leader has been quick to reject public offers of aid from the U.S. and initially even blamed America for the outbreak.
متهمید به اینکه این ویروس رو شما تولید کردید.
Former President Mahmoud Ahmadinejad is a hardliner who pushed Iran's nuclear program and brought on many sanctions from the West during his term. He's added his voice to the chorus of conspiracy theories about the origin of the virus.
It's nice to see you again. You've said before that the coronavirus was a bioweapon made by world powers. Do you still believe that?
همه میدونن ویروس آزمایشگاهی است، اما سر اینکه چه کسی اینو در جامعه منتشر کرده با هم دیگه اختلاف داریم.
What would the purpose be to create a coronavirus in a lab? Why would a country do that?
شما فکر می‌کنی هدف از تولید بمب اتم چی هست؟ هدف از تولید بمب شیمیایی چی هست؟ چون شیطان دنبال برتری جویی است. ریشه اختلافات، دعواها، جنگ‌ها، فاصله طبقاتی، فقرها همش در اینه که یه عده می‌خوان برتر از دیگران باشن. تسلط بر دیگران داشته باشن.
I wanted to ask you about sanctions with Trump's policy of maximum pressure on Iran at this time of a pandemic. What has the impact of that been?
خب تحریم ها که برطرف نشده. ببینید تحریم هم یه اسلحه ایست. این همون انحصارگریه. برتری جویی است. ما با این مخالف.
Even before coronavirus, this past year was one of the most challenging periods in the 40-year history of the Islamic Republic. After scrapping the Iranian nuclear deal in 2018, President Trump launched a maximum pressure campaign on Iranian individuals, banking, oil, and shipping. Under these sanctions, Iran saw its economy shrink by 7.6% in 2019. During a mass uprising against the government in November, hundreds of Iranians were reportedly killed. Then, in January, the United States assassinated the country's top general, Qasem Soleimani, pushing Iran to the brink of war.
Nations have tolerated Iran's destructive and destabilizing behavior in the Middle East and beyond. Those days are over.
As the coronavirus spread, Iran's foreign minister charged America with committing medical terrorism through increasingly severe sanctions.
The U.S. government has vengefully refused to lift its unlawful and collective punishment.
The Trump administration says Iran has neglected health care while spending $16 billion to fund terror proxies since 2012, and has a track record of appropriating funds intended for medical supplies. That's led the U.S. to threaten a veto of Iran's first ever request for an emergency loan from the International Monetary Fund.
I hope that the Iranian regime will respond to the Iranian people's demands rather than continuing their global terror campaign.
While the U.S. maintains that its sanctions don't prevent humanitarian supplies from reaching Iran, human rights organizations say they severely impact access to medicine, protective gear, and hospital equipment. Scarcity has pushed Iranians to improvise new solutions.
یه ونتیلاتور مثلا قیمتش میشه تا 200 الی 300 برابر این دستا قیمتش میشه. چه و خب عموماً سیستم‌های بهداشتی توانمندی این حجم سرمایه پول رو ندارن که تامین کنن و این مشکل حل بشه.
Mustafa Darafshian is working to design and mass produce an open source ventilator at Tehran University.
کاری که الان داریم می‌کنیم رو بحث اینه که کالیبرش کنیم، دقتش رو ببریم بالا و فکر کنم به زودی بتونیم اینا رو هم تثبیت کنیم. یه سری تجهیزات اندازه‌گیری داریم تهیه می‌کنیم که اینا رو بتونیم اندازه بگیریم و تثبیتش کنیم و به یه نقطه استیبلی برسونیم.
When we don't have all the resources to get from outside, we have to build it in Iran.
Darafshian works with Dr. Hadi Muradi on a project to combine designs from MIT in the US with parts from inside Iran.
We had many difficulties because of the sanctions, which has affected the scientific community a lot. Even the humanitarian activities have been limited by these sanctions. And this is unfortunate because the politics is, we have to put somewhere, and the people should not suffer from these things. Having low-cost ventilators and built in Iran, it can help us, first of all, to be on our own feet and be able to not rely on other countries.
With limited resources, Iran's medical system is weathering the crisis as best they can. Imam Khomeini Hospital is one of the biggest in Tehran. As the country opens up under intense economic pressure, doctors here are worried about a resurgence of COVID-19.
قبلا مثلا از صبح تا شب 40 تا 45 تا بود. زمانی که محدودیت ها اجرا می شد اومده بود رو 20 تا، اینا الان دوباره رفته بالا.
هفته 18 یه مایساز آسیب. چی میخوای بابا؟
This man has been in the ICU for nearly 2 months and is seeing his son for the first time since being hospitalized. As the world copes with the coronavirus, Iran is garnering increased sympathy against sanctions from outside, if only to help slow the coronavirus in the Middle East. The UK has reportedly put private pressure on the US, while the UN and countries like Russia and China are calling for sanctions to be rolled back. Even President Ahmadinejad is now advocating so-called corona diplomacy with a country he would routinely threaten while in office.
The coronavirus outbreak is affecting countries all over the world now. You know, Israel, for example, has 13,000 confirmed cases and 150 deaths. What advice do you have?
امروز روز همکاری است. باید تمام کینه‌های گذشته کنار گذاشته بشه. دعواهای نژادی، دعواهای مذهبی، دعوا برای قدرت، دعوا برای سرزمین، دعواهای اقتصادی و سیاسی. امروز روز همکاری است.
What is the future for Iran? Because it's been a very tumultuous last few months.
ملت ایران یک ملت بزرگه، یک ملت دارای تاریخ و تمدن و فرهنگ، از این سختی‌ها عبور خواهد کرد.
As Iran's political leadership struggles to find ways out of a web of sanctions and international pressure, the country's brightest minds are now in a race to find treatments for COVID-19. At the Royan Institute in Tehran, researchers are working with stem cells.
ما الان کارآزمایی بالینی مختلفی رو شروع کردیم که میشه گفتش که شاید مشابه اون رو هم حتی در دنیا ندید. محصولات سلولی به شکل استنشاقی و اینهالیشن با نبولایزر که این امکان رو میده که این فراورده های سلولی به راحتی به مجاری تنفسی و ریه بیمار برسن و این امکان بهبود شرایط بیمار رو خب قاعدتا تسهیل خواهد.
سبشون مردم همه دور هم جمع بشن، صحنه های خیلی خاص در واقع به نظر من رقم زده شد و زیبایی های خاصی رو ما دیدیم، نه تنها در دنیای علمی بلکه شما می‌بینید آدم ها به هم نزدیک شدن. تکامل حاصل چالشه. وقتی که چالش به وجود میاد در طی تکامل قاعدتا بعضی از گونه ها از بین میرن، اما بعضی از گونه ها اگر بتونن صفت جدیدی رو به دست بیارن خب تبدیل میشن به موجوداتی توانمندتر که میتونن حتی در شرایط یا کنام یا نیچه سخت هم رشد بکنن و فزونی پیدا بکنن و حرکت بکنن.